Hi, my name is Jared Jacon Duffy, and today me and my group will be speaking about why we believe that you should implement a Philosophy for Children program at Drayton Mills Elementary School. I mean, just let's face it, I don't remember a single thing I learned in fourth grade history class, and that's not because I'm a bad student or unintelligent, it's just simply an unavoidable truth of the school system. But implementing a Philosophy for Children program is an opportunity to teach children and expand their cognitive abilities, teach them how to learn and think. Children are full of wonder, and this is an opportunity for them to learn how to properly build beliefs that are based out of solid premises and support. Philosophy for Children programs have been shown to build relationships among students, as well as with their teachers, open up a channel of communication to further enhance the classroom setting, not just academically, but socially and emotionally as well. Additionally, philosophy and STEM majors have shown to test the highest on the GRE, the MCAT, the GMAT, and the LSAT. And this is not because of philosophy majors committing all that time to studying the material and subject matter. It's because they've developed the way that they think and their cognitive abilities. And that's what's enabling them to be successful.
I'm John Wilson, and we believe that implementing Philosophy for Children programs in elementary schools is very important. However, through the demographics of Chapman and Houston, the two elementary schools that's going to be providing most of the students for Drayton Mills Elementary School, that implementing this program is even more beneficial. If we look at the two schools, you have Chapman and Houston. Chapman has around 385 students, and their free and reduced lunch total is about 91% of that. If you look at Houston, they have about 322 students, and their free and reduced lunch total is about 90%. Doing the math and calculating, there's gonna be about a total of 645 students that's on free and reduced lunch. That leaves about 62 students that are not. So we look at the Urban Institute, and they've done some research, and it says that about 22.8% of students that live below poverty, they're saying this by living below poverty at least half your life up to the age of 18, will go to college before the age of 25. Only 3.2% of those students are actually going to graduate. So if we compare that to the demographics at Chapman, that's around 21 students that's going to graduate college. Now, if we take the other half of this, so there's about 70% of students that are not in the poverty that's gonna go to college before the age of 25. Around 36.5% of those students will graduate college. And if we look at that compared to the demographics of Chapman and Houston, that's around 23 students that's gonna graduate college. This is an extremely important, relevant number, because although the ratio is about 10 times higher, there's more students that's not living under poverty that's gonna graduate from college. As we have seen through results, developing critical and cognitive thinking skills have increased test scores. This is very important in aiding students going to college and taking college admissions tests such as the ACT and the SAT. Additionally, having this course of Philosophy for Children will aid students that do not have the opportunity of going to college, and they'll get these cognitive and critical thinking skills now than they might not otherwise have gotten.
Yep. Hello everyone, Bill Rosa here. Implementing Philosophy for Children program can raise concerns with children, parents, and the school.
Students may not be receptive to our philosophy program, resulting in a lack of participation and learning. The parents of Drayton Mills Elementary might not want their child learning this because other skills and subjects are higher priority, such as grammar, math, spelling, and history.
The school itself is worried about P4C being a waste of time and money. But with our system, this eliminates our concern due to our 30-minute block once a week. It's ran by teachers and driven by students. This is our system right here, our thinking circle. It's an open and creative discussion among students, utilizing core concepts to develop an understanding of the world we live in. This is built around our three core concepts. First, we're going to start with our first core concept of building blocks in our critical thinking circle. Building blocks consist of three categories, which are open-mindedness, respect, and conflict resolution. These three categories are needed to create a successful environment in our thinking circle.
Our next two core concepts are up under cognitive thinking skills that can be utilized within the thinking circle. The first one is cause and effect. When these cause and effect, we have three fundamentals. One is the understanding of what cause and effect is. The two is a practice and a daily use that you can use every single day. And the last one is the effects of decision making. Cause and effect is important because a lot of people do not understand how cause and effect affects their lives, and this is a skill and a thinking skill that can be improved upon through practicing and understanding and grasping of the concept.
The second thinking skill is titled Belief Basics. It is a focus on the premise-conclusion formatting of arguments. It is used to teach children about how we should have evidence for the beliefs and things that we think, but also how different people can have different opinions and how those opinions can be formed because of their different experiences or their own beliefs. It's a way for children and adults as a whole to understand one another, work better together, and get further as a society.
We got a program for P4C Hawaii. They do a great job of incorporating all the ideas that we want, but it takes sometimes a short acclimation period for things to get started.
That's why we're hoping to incorporate the core concepts and give our program a jump start so that it can more quickly become a proficient and effective program.
If our program's not for you, then stick to P4C Hawaii.